The other area that we also have tested and assessed is the whole area of the financial health of the municipalities. The question is, when all is said and done, and all these internal control weaknesses have been identified and corrected, does the municipal municipality still have money to do the things that it ought to do with regards to the delivery of services? And our overall assessment is that many of them are starting to incur net deficits, meaning that the total amount of resources available for them to spend are starting to be exceeded by the amounts of money that they are committed to in the form of expenditures. Hence, they end up with a net deficit instead of a net surplus. That's a high-risk area which needs to be looked at, particularly in a tight fiscal environment like we are operating in. We are also seeing signs of certain of the current liabilities within municipalities starting to exceed the current assets, which indicates that to be in a net current liability position, those assets that are supposed to be available for the continuation of the delivery of services are starting to disappear over time. And also the area of the management of cash. A lot of municipalities that we have analyzed in this report are taking too long to collect the debt that comes on the back of the services that have already been consumed. However, when they have to make their payments to their suppliers, they are normally pushed to pay much earlier or to pay quicker, which means that the bulk of the cash that is supposed to be made available for use in the municipality is largely for a long period of time sitting in somebody else's pocket, which is raising issues of the liquidity of the municipality. Does the municipality always have sufficient cash resources to meet its obligations as and when they arise? And so we want to flag this matter to say that there is a high risk of uncertainty with regards to a number of these municipalities' ability to continue in the foreseeable future, because they are now starting to face a tight financial situation, but that's also compounded largely by the weaknesses in their internal control environment. And the other point which we also flagged in this report, we've also looked at how the grants, as we appreciate the money that is used in municipalities, some of it is collected through the rates and all of that, but part of it is also allocated from the central revenue fund. And of course, our reflection in terms of this report is to say that a lot of this expenditure that is received on the back of the likes of your municipal infrastructure grant, on the back of your municipal systems improvement grant, is all being allocated for expenditure. However, there is still a significant weakness when it comes to assessing the performance of these projects against targets. So we want to draw attention to this matter to say that let there be a requisite level of control that is put into ensuring that the performance and the targets against which these grants are given is also followed through and reported on. Because if it is not, and the monies are spent, it is possible, as we have seen in some of these municipalities, that what was intended in respect of the grant gets diverted towards other things that were not initially what the purpose of the grant funding was. And as I get closer to the end of my briefing, we've also taken note of some of the key attributes that are necessary for municipalities to make further improvements. And we think these, from page 8 to page 9, will be a important input that needs to go into the work plans of the new councils that will take office come post August 3 period. And ourselves as an audit office, as always, are committing to work closely with those councillors when they take office in the second part of this year to make sure that the stuff that has been achieved, as well as the challenges that have already been identified, do not go back to zero when new people take office. But there is a proper handover process that between ourselves and the respective levels of oversight in Parliament and within the institutions are going to be seized with to ensure that this continuous journey that has culminated in these outcomes in 2014-15 is not allowed to regress. Because as we were analyzing the five-year period, we saw that in the 2010-2011 period, there was a little bit of a dip because of those changeovers and long vacancies that arise, among others. And we hope that with these audit outcomes, there will probably be a safer transitional process.